story to tell. According to Chinese media, recently, the Chinese People's Liberation Army announced that it had conducted a test of a new anti-tank missile system. A footage shows a rocket brigade from the Northern Theater Command conducted a live fire test. Beijing didn't specify exactly which system was involved in the recent exercise, but analysts have speculated it likely was the HJ-10, a vehicle-loaded guided missile. According to the Ministry of Defense of China, drills were held in the highlands of the country to practice high-precision strikes. The Chinese HJ-10 anti-tank missile, also known as the Red Arrow 10, is a Chinese ground-launched anti-tank missile developed by Norinco. This is a Chinese clone of the Israeli spy NLOS, uses the same technology. The HJ-10 can be also seen as a scaled-down version of the Chinese CM501G land attack missile. The HJ-10 is 1,850 mm long and 165 mm in diameter. It has a tandem high-explosive anti-tank warhead that may penetrate 1,400 mm of conventional steel armor protected by explosive reactive armor. The maximum range is 10 kilometers. The missile has an optical or imaging guidance system. It is non-line-of-sight missile. It can lock on the target within the line of sight. Alternatively, the operator locks on the target after the launch, using a real-time image from the missile. Commands to the missile are transmitted via a two-way fiber optic cable. Air-launched variants for helicopters and drones have also been developed. Previously, HJ-10 was hailed by Chinese media as the most powerful long-range anti-tank missile in the world today. The SJ-10 has been deployed to the PLA since 2012 on track vehicles as the AFT-10 anti-tank weapon carrier. China is continuing to work on anti-tank missiles with longer ranges. HJ-10 was developed to combat enemy armor such as the US-made M1A2 Abrams main battle tank or the Indian T-72 and T-80 tanks. A year ago, Taipei announced that it would buy the American-built Abrams and other hardware in a deal worth $2.2 billion, pending congressional approval. Taiwan has sought to purchase the Abrams for more than a decade to bolster its aging tank force. The island nation remains one of the last operators of the Cold War era M60 Bantam tank, which Taipei has steadily updated in recent years. HJ-10 could certainly take on the Soviet-era T-72 and T-80 tanks currently being deployed in the Ladakh Valley along the border with India. China deployed the all-terrain light armor vehicles used to carry the HJ-10 missile launcher to the region in August. The recent test suggests that Beijing has great confidence in the platform, whether in an amphibious landing or in a mountainous assault. Both China and India have deployed troops and armored vehicles to the line of actual control in recent weeks. The PLA's drills come as China-India relations are at their worst in decades. My video of HJ-10 anti-tank missile ends here. Thank you for watching. If you find this video interesting, please give me your thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to support the channel. Goodbye and see you again in the next videos. Thank you.
ở ngoài một đêm thấy xe mình sạch sẽ hẳn à.